the middleweight tournaments, and let's go to the light heavyweights. Let's talk about John Pascal, Bernard Hopkins, the next fight that we'll be counting punches for on HBO. We both, it sounds like we're both picking Bernard Hopkins to win the fight. Do you, what do you think about Bernard Hopkins having the belt, though? Is he going to take on the Chad Dawsons or the other comers in the division, or?
Shall wait and see. You don't know. I mean, Bernard Hopkins is the grandfather of the boxing game right now. He's been around for years. You've seen his body at work. We can't hash over that right now. But right now, you know, at the point of his career, I think he's just trying to like cement his legacy. If he wins the light heavyweight championship again, he just signed that deal with HBO, so he's gonna have to fight someone. And he's gonna be contracted to fight Chad Dawson next. Will he do it though? That's the question. I personally don't have any interest in that fight because I think it'd be very safety first instinct. But at the same time, Hopkins turning back another young buck and possibly cleaning out the light heavyweight division would just be like the icing on the cake for his legendary career.
Right, and even though if Hopkins won, he would be the champion, it seems like if Pascal won, he'd be the one with more of the options because he could always go into a rematch with Dawson. There's other guys out there like Tavoris Cloud that he'd be willing to fight.
I think that'd be a tremendous fight, Tavoris Cloud and Pascal.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. So
you know, I mean, it's the same thing. You don't like it would be amazing for Hopkins to win the fight. It'd be good for Pascal to win the fight. I mean, they're both very credible guys. The first fight was very exciting, surprising to everyone how exciting it was. So this rematch, I mean, especially the way you saw them at that face-to-face with Max Kellerman, how that acted. Hopkins, I think, still when it comes down to it, he has such a great mind for boxing. I think he's still too crafty for a guy like Pascal, who still is trying to be like Roy Jones, his idol.
And going back to this past weekend, Wilfredo Vasquez Jr. wasn't the only son of a legend that was in action. We also had Aaron Pryor Jr., the son of the great Aaron Pryor, the Hawk, in action. and he won an 8-round decision versus Liberato Andrade, traditionally a tough guy who's went toe-to-toe with Boutte, Lucien Boutte, in their first fight and lost by knockout in their second fight. Pryor Jr. is 32 years old. He got into boxing really late. Does he have a future within the division?
Well, he's one that, you know what, I mean, even though he's not young, he's still one of the up-and-comers in the super middleweight division, which is one of the deepest, if not the deepest division in boxing, you know. So Pryor Jr., he fits right in there. He had a very good fight with Edwin Rodriguez. He beat Dia Davis, who just recently upset Marcus Johnson.
Right.
So, I mean, Pryor Jr.'s right in there, and he just beat Liberato Andrade, who's been, like, you know, the mainstay gatekeeper of the 168-pound division. So with that win, I think Pryor Jr. now definitely can step up to a show, opening Showtime fight. Do I think he's going to become a champion? Probably not, but you know what? He's a very good fighter.
Right, and hopefully we'll get to see Senior at the Boxing Hall of Fame weekend.
Definitely.
Coming
he'll
up
be
in
there.
June.
He'll be there. I'll leave it at this. If Pryor Jr. had fought Kelly Pavlik this past weekend, I think Pryor Jr. would have won.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. I'm sure Senior is happy to hear that. Let's go back because it's been a while since we've been on the air. Let's cover another big story. We brought it up before. Victor Ortiz beats Andre Berto in a fight of the year candidate. Mm-hmm. Back and forth action. 3 knockdowns in the fight. And a lot of people picked Berto to win the fight because Ortiz, I guess, was moving up.
Mm-hmm.
And Ortiz looks like a legitimate welterweight now.
He does. He does. Victor Ortiz, I mean, what a performance he put on. You know, really strong, determined. He put on a great fight. He dropped Berto. Berto had that look in his eyes after he got knocked down the first time, looking around, you know, probably looking for Al Haymon or someone else, going, oh my God, I'm in a real fight now.
Right.
And to his credit, Berto did fight back. He dropped Ortiz really hard in the 6th round, but Ortiz fought like a man possessed. He kept on coming. He had that warrior spirit, and he wasn't going to be denied that night. And if he fights like that every time out, I'm going to become a fan of him.
Right.
And I think he has an intriguing fight with Floyd Mayweather, if that would ever come off.
I think he's too wet behind the ears for the Mayweather fight.
I don't expect him to beat Mayweather, but if he fights with that determination, he has power, he has speed, he has good skills, he does have a good shot against anyone, and he's a welcome addition to the 147-pound class.
That's true, and boxing is always welcoming of a rebirth. And here's a guy who, we all know about what happened versus Maidana when he quit.
I think he finally put that behind him.
Mm-hmm.
And I expect to have a rematch with Maidana. I expect him to have a rematch with Maidana eventually, which I think he would win.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, you know, people still had his doubts. He's a quitter and all that. Especially the way he acquitted himself, especially after he got knocked down in the 6th, he knew from there he silenced his critics.
Right, and Ortiz seems to be a guy who's, you know, he's a country guy. He seems like that he's in real life, he seems like he's just a nice laid-back guy. Mm-hmm. If the Maidana fight, if the perception that he's a quitter is the chip on his shoulder that motivates him to fight like he did versus Andre Berto, then I welcome it.
Exactly. Totally agree.
Good. This is a very good redemption for Ortiz. We're looking forward to seeing him fight. We're looking forward to seeing Berto fight, too, because he's a good fighter. And let's mention two things before we